The U.S. has led the global evolution of military drones, deploying a wide range of systems over the decades. Now they have served in roles from high-altitude surveillance to precision strikes and electronic warfare. Developed for reconnaissance during the Cold War, they became central to the U.S. operations in the 21st century, offering persistent presence and reduced risk to pilots. Let's check out the evolution of U.S. military drones, and in this list we will not include small and miniature models as well, but we will be publishing them separately. The Interstate TDR. This was one of the world's first operational combat drones, deployed by the U.S. Navy during World War II, and it was a radio-controlled assault aircraft that carried a 2,000-pound or 910-kilogram bombs or torpedo and was designed for one-way missions. It had a cruising speed of about 140 miles per hour, with an endurance around 1 hour. There was no stealth technology and its effectiveness was limited by poor precision. The TDR was retired quickly in late 1944 due to rapid advances in manned aviation and limited tactical need. The AAI RQ-2 Pioneer. The RQ-2 Pioneer was developed for the U.S. Navy, Army, and Marine Corps in the 1980s as a tactical ISR platform. It had an endurance of about 5 hours and flew at speeds around 120 miles per hour. Designed primarily for battlefield observation, it could carry a payload of roughly 75 pounds usually and electro-optical infrared sensor. It had no stealth capabilities and was often launched from ships using rocket-assisted takeoff and recovered using nets. The system was retired in 2007. The RQ-5A Hunter. This was a twin-borne tactical drone designed for medium-altitude reconnaissance for the U.S. Army. It had an endurance of about 21 hours and could reach speeds of up to 120 miles per hour. The drone carried up to 300 pounds of payload, typically including electro-optical or infrared sensors, and later variants were tested with Viper Strike precision-guided munitions. It had no stealth features and relied on line-of-sight data links for control. Number 4. The MQ-1 Predator. The MQ-1 Predator became one of the most iconic U.S. military drones, entering service in 1995. It had a long endurance of around 24 hours and cruised at approximately 80 to 100 miles per hour. With a payload capacity of about 450 pounds, it was the first drone equipped with AGM-114 Hellfire missiles, allowing for both ISR and precision strike missions. Its video surveillance and strike capabilities made it a centerpiece in counterterrorism missions in Iraq, Afghanistan, and elsewhere. The MQ-1 was retired from active U.S. Air Force service in 2018. The Northrop Grumman RQ-4 Global Hawk. This is a high-altitude, long-endurance surveillance drone that entered U.S. Air Force service in 2001. It is capable of flying at altitudes up to 60,000 feet or 18,000 meters with an impressive endurance of over 34 hours. The drone had a cruising speed of around 357 miles per hour. It carries an advanced sensor suite that includes synthetic aperture radar, electro-optic infrared cameras, and signal intelligence equipment. Although it lacks stealth, its high-altitude flight and broad sensor coverage makes it ideal for strategic ISR missions over vast areas. The AAI RQ-7 Shadow. This is a tactical UAV developed by AAI Corporation for short to mid-range reconnaissance, surveillance, and target acquisition. It entered U.S. Army service in 2002 and has an endurance of approximately 6 to 9 hours, flying at speeds of around 81 miles per hour. The Shadow typically carries electro-optic infrared cameras with a payload limit near 60 pounds. It provides high-quality battlefield situational awareness. The RQ-7 has proven highly reliable for ground force support in Iraq and Afghanistan. At number 7, the General Atomics MQ-9 Reaper. The MQ-9 Reaper is a successor to the MQ-1 that entered service in 2007, built for both ISR and hunter-killer roles, and became the primary armed drone for the U.S. Air Force in the 2010s. It has an endurance of up to 40 hours and cruises at around 180 to 200 miles per hour with a top speed of about 240 miles per hour. It carries a payload of 3,800 pounds, including precision weapons like Hellfire missiles, GBU-12 PAVE-2 bombs, and GBU-38 JDAMs. While it lacks radar stealth, its altitude range and lethal precision makes it extremely effective. The Lockheed Martin RQ-170 Sentinel. This is a stealthy, high-altitude reconnaissance drone operated by the US Air Force and CIA. It first entered service in 2007. It has an estimated endurance of over 6 hours and an estimated speed of 300 to 500 miles per hour. Its payload is classified but likely includes electro-optic infrared, radar, and signals intelligence sensors, all within an internal bay. The aircraft features radar-absorbing materials and a flying wing design for reduced radar cross-section. It played a role in their surveillance of Osama bin Laden's compound prior to the 2011 raid. The General Atomics MQ-1C Grey Eagle. This is an upgraded derivative of the MQ-1 Predator that entered service in 2009, developed specifically for the US Army to support long-endurance armed reconnaissance missions. It has an endurance of over 25 hours and a cruise speed of around 150 miles per hour. The drone can carry a 1,075 pounds payload, including electro-optic infrared sensors, SAR, and up to 4 Hellfire missiles for precision strike. Its rugged design and integration with Army ground forces make it a key tactical asset. The AeroVironMon T-20. This is a medium-range unmanned aircraft system used primarily by the US Army for reconnaissance and target acquisition. It entered service around 2009 and has an endurance of approximately 24 hours depending on payload and configuration. It cruises at speeds of up to 70 miles per hour. The T-20 can carry about 25 to 35 pounds of payload, typically including electro-optic infrared sensors for day and night surveillance. It offers a quiet, low-signature presence. Although larger than miniature drones, the T-20 remains compact and is often confused with Group 1 UAS. The Boeing In-Situ RQ-21 Blackjack. This is a small tactical UAV used by the US Navy and Marine Corps for shipborne and expeditionary ISR missions. Entering service in 2014, it offers a maximum endurance of approximately 16 hours and cruises at speeds of 63 miles per hour. It carries a modular payload of about 39 pounds, typically consisting of electro-optic infrared sensors, communications relay, and maritime radar. The Blackjack has no stealth characteristics and is not weaponized, focusing purely on reconnaissance and surveillance. The Northrop Grumman RQ-180. The RQ-180 is a highly classified next-generation stealth UAV, reportedly developed for the US Air Force and believed to have entered service around 2015. While specific details are restricted, it is thought to be a high-altitude, long-endurance strategic ISR drone and advanced low-observable features. It likely has an endurance exceeding 24 hours and is designed to operate in denied or contested airspace. Estimated speeds are subsonic, possibly cruising in the range of 400 to 500 miles per hour. The airframe uses a flying wing design, similar to the B-2 bomber, for enhanced radar evasion. Its payload is expected to include multispectral sensors, synthetic aperture radar, and electronic intelligence systems. The Northrop Grumman MQ-4C Triton. The MQ-4C Triton is a naval variant of the RQ-4 Global Hawk, developed for long-range maritime ISR missions. It entered service with the US Navy in 2018 and is capable of flying over 30 hours at altitudes of up to 56,500 feet, with a maximum speed of around 357 miles per hour. It is optimized for wide-area surveillance over oceans and coastal regions. The Triton carries a powerful sensor suite, including maritime radar, electro-optic infrared systems, and signals intelligence equipment, with a payload capacity of around 3,200 pounds. Triton provides real-time data to the Navy's P-8 Poseidon crews, creating a persistent reconnaissance network. With this, we're winding up for today, but stay tuned and we'll bring you more updates from the world of military. We'll see you guys again in our next video. Bye-bye.